Welcome back to the workshop for another kit review for you. Up next is AMT's 39 Wagon Rod. This is a resto mod. This availability is only be built in the resto mod design. There is no stock building availability. These were huge back in the 90s. Remember Tim Allen? He built a lot of cars like this. Classic, gorgeous chop body, but then all modern underpinnings, modern wheels, tires, interior, and drivetrain underneath the sweet retro body. It's in 1/25th scale. Let's take a look at everything that's going to be in the box. First up is going to be the manual. The engine you get with this is an LT5 V8. You get modern big and little tires, and then you get your frame, and you'll go on to assemble the modern style interior, and then move on to painting and decaling and attaching the Restomod chop top body. So let's put the paperwork aside, get through some styrene. First up in this one will be all the big pieces. Let's show the big pieces first this time. You get a one-piece lower body. You can see the back's got the nice wood grain in it. We'll get a real close-up shot of that. You can see the running boards got their retro-style grooves. We got those gorgeous fenders. That front end, oh, makes you want to give it a big old kiss. I like that big piece of plastic. Nice and smooth, too. It's going to be easy to paint. Show you underneath. A little bit of bodywork detail underneath there. We'll set that aside. We'll go to the wagon body. Check that out. We got our exterior and interior wood trim. We got that beautiful big scallop coming out of there. We got the chop top with the solid windows. Now, you customizer guys could cut those out. The line is very defined, and you could add your own windows for that if you wanted that glass in there. And you can see that nice nose. Top underneath, nice and plain. Just got our little interior dome light there. We've got the nice frame, which is straight. Always like to see the stuff not come out warped. Full frame. Beautiful look in there. And we've got that nice stretched skinny hood. The trim is prominent enough that you'll be able to bare metal foil it or silver paint it quite easily. So nice, so nice. What else we have up? Let's get all the rest of the white plastic out on the table. First up, interior panels. You can see those modern style interior panels. All the comforts of modern electronics with all the style of the old body. Nice bucket seats. You just fold right in those. Then we've got various small suspension and drivetrain parts. Take a look at those there. Over here we've got the full exhaust system, differential, drive shaft. On this tree here we've got our wheel backs. We've got our modern style steering wheel right there. We've got some small suspension parts. Got our steering column with cluster. Got our shifter. Look at the small detail on that. And over here we've got modern disc with calipers. Like I said, Restomod. Very, very cool. Got our LT5 engine, transmission, electric fans, intake. It's got that sweet snorkel style intake on the motor. Headers. This engine is broken down into numerous parts. Battery with actual cable and line detail on it. Pulley system, firewall, and check this out. We'll flip the tree one more time. Look at that modern dash under there. Is that not sweet or what? I mean, that is pretty tight with all three pedals, just like you should have. Now, what else is in the kit? We've got some chrome. We've got clear glass. Let's look at the chrome first. These are your modern wheels. Now, I'd leave these nice and bright chrome with a wash, or if you shot them with some dull coat, those would look just like aluminum over that chrome. There's the grill. A nice wash inside that grill will bring out every single one of those lines and look just perfect. Again, if you want it to look like aluminum or cast metal, hit your chrome with a shot of dull coat. That's all you need to do. A matte medium, a flat coat clear. There's your intake with the snorkel attachment. That'll bring them looking down right just like metal. In the bag here, I don't want to scratch these because this kit's definitely a builder. We've got our chop windshield, headlights, back glass right there. Nice and clear, not too thick. You also have the option of tinted windows. I like that. I like that smoke look. I'd definitely be using it on the back glass and probably using the clear on the windshield. I think that would be the best combination. We've got some big and little tires. These are definitely modern rubber. Those are going to hook up when you stand on the horsepower. Goodyear branded all the way around. We'll see if we can get it in close enough. Let the camera focus on that. Solid tires. Beautifully done. Beautiful. Front tires are also Goodyear branded with a superb tread pattern in them. And you can see those are Goodyear branded as well. Nice tires. Round 2 is always knocking it out of the park with the tires. Save one of the coolest things for the last part of the review. This gorgeous decal sheet. Now this right there goes in if you leave the back glass in and put that over it. Oh, that's beautiful. Got all kinds of cute catchphrases. Now one thing I want to point out. The decals for the wood grain, separate. These are separate pieces. You know why I'm going to keep saying separate? Because that is awesome. Thank you, Round 2. If this was all one piece, you'd go through a half a gallon of decal set trying to get it to sink into that body molding. These being separate, you can cut each piece out, lay it in, tamp it down, give it a little decal set, probably wouldn't even need it, and they'll stick right in. It's going to save you a lot of time and a lot of screaming. We've got some white lettering in there that's a little bit harder to see. It says low frequency here. It says Lucky and Bibby here. It's got a couple other names and scroll work in white, otherwise all the different colors. You could make it a pizza wagon, fast and fresh. Here comes the pizza wagon. We got AMT logos. We got Speed Trap, Pure Fiction, lowrider emblems, license plates, beautiful scallop and scroll and paintwork. So you've got a lot of options with that decal sheet. I would have to use those, though. I mean, just I keep looking at that because that makes me really excited. So anyways, before I'm rambling too much, that is a 39 wagon rod. Very, very cool resto mod kit. I plan on building this one for sure, so stay tuned to the channel, and I'll see you at the next review.